He also says it's still funny to hear Microsoft call for open and shared. Is it really an open and shared? It was more just preservation, right? Like making it available. It didn't say that you couldn't make money off of it. It's not like they're giving away these games for free.
I'm sure they want to make they understand the desire to make a buck.
We can preserve and we can learn from the history and make this history available for new people on the platform and make a couple bucks in the process. This is the dream. Good.
Trying to find. There was an article, and it was about. I can't remember if it was on The Verge. I'm thinking I pocketed it. It was on VentureBeat, and it was the three pillars of why Xbox is thriving. Mm-hmm. It was a really interesting article and highly worth a read. But it talks about how they're reaching players wherever they are. They're investing in variety.
Mm-hmm.
They're investing in quality. And the whole thing of where you are is, you know, they don't care if you're on PC. They don't care if you're on a mobile device. Well,
There was some execs, I don't know if it's Phil Spencer or somebody else, that says very shortly there will be more people playing Xbox games on mobile than our consoles, and we know this,
and they don't care,
and we don't care. We just want you playing,
right?
We just want you on our platform, and
so I thought it was pretty.
It
was, like I said, it was a pretty good article. I agree with the quality,
mm-hmm.
And to me, bringing back or preserving those, like we were talking about, you can spin up a virtual version. Or a virtual version of the operating system from whatever system,
mm-hmm.
and run it.
It's kind of the dream, isn't it? This is something of a pipe dream for Microsoft with desktops, and I know they're rolling out a new version of that, or others are, or however. I don't know. It was part of Office. They're doing like virtual desktops or something now, right? Like that we talked about like a couple months ago, maybe a few weeks ago.
Yeah, there was that was your first way to kick the tires on Windows 11. I think officially was to get one of their virtual desktops, and they mm-hmm. came at like different prices for the different specs.
Yeah, but I mean that's all coming off of like the success of like here I'm on my iPad pulling up, you know, iCloud. I can sit on that Mac Mini M1. It doesn't matter that nothing runs on it anymore on the Mac side. I can pull all these games up. I can pull up Batman and Wolfenstein and Avengers and Halo and Dragon Ball Z fighting game and Grand Theft Auto like that. And that's only going to expand as they mm-hmm. keep fleshing this out. And this is still in beta, guys. You know, it's ridiculous. And even NVIDIA GeForce is doing the same thing, right? And kind of making that interesting. It'll just be curious to see what happens here in the future with all these. So. Be very, very interesting.